for everything. You take better care of me than I do myself.
Boy, you're healing well. I'll leave a scar, though.
That's all right. I sort of take pride in them now.
I'm just good to see you find your strength.
Callie, there's something wrong.
I might not always be around here for you. That's all. I've been so busy with you, Hoy, Lucia. I failed to be there for Augustus, my people.
Callie, that's my fault, right?
It's mine. As long as I've known Augustus, we've been outsiders. But lately, the way you trust the sheriff, it's hard to know if we're still on the same side.
I suppose if we can no longer trust our friends, who can we trust?
We could still do it. Open the cantina. I got a little bit of money left. Maybe not enough. But you and me riding together again, we could time
it. No.
Just think about it.
I got our own full here and independent.
You name me one thing the two of us ever put our minds to, we couldn't pull off.
I can't opt to go to Mexico on a whim.
Why not? Tell me, why not? Hey, all that money we made stealing cattle, I never told anyone that was your idea.
I'm just asking you, do me a favor, Tom, okay?
Why are you really here, Eli?
I told you.
No, the real reason, first you come out of the blue, and now you're selling me on an old daydream like your life depends on it. Why are you really here?
Because, damn it, I won't make it out there without your help.
And I'm really tired of running, Tom.
Eli, who are you running from?
Morning, Sheriff.
Morning, Gus.
New batch of warrants just arrived earlier today.
Yeah, I'm heading in soon. Can we discuss it then?
Afraid one can't wait. Eli McDowell. You know, somebody in town thought they spotted him early today. McDowell's wanted for cattle theft, fraud, and murder. It's a huge bounty on this guy's head.
Rick, appreciate you telling me.
Yeah, one more thing. If Eli McDowell is in the area, it won't be for long. Gil Santiago's after him. You heard him, right?
Only rumors.
Yeah. He respects the bounty more than the badge. He will get in our way if we don't move fast. So I figured that I'd take a ride off and take a look.
No.
I'd
like you to wait for me. And, your friend, the Apache tracker.
Callahan.
Yeah. Both of you, go to the bridge overlooking the town and do not do anything until I get there. You got it? Where the hell do you go, Eli?
Oh, wait, it's practically noon. Which begs the question, where do you sleep anyway?
You know, here and there.
Oh, I want to guess this one. All right, it's Wednesday. And they muck out the stables on Wednesday, so you didn't sleep there. I'm going to say that you bunked at the Undertaker's again.
Hey, I appreciate the quiet.
Do you?
I do.
I'm sure.
Tell you. Augustus, been looking for you. Sheriff wants your help. We're tracking down an outlaw, Eli McDowell.
Of course. What do you know about him?
I'll be out on the ridge when you're ready. And
there's something very wrong about this picture.
And what is that?
I'm the only person who doesn't work for Tom Davidson. Rest of y'all are at his damn beck and call.
Oh, please.
You run this place for him. Abby's his clerk. Callahan's his tracker. But me, I'm beholden to no man. A genuine renegade.
Hmm, you're a genuine something.
I'll prove it to you. Tom and Gus are riding out of town, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm going to break into Tom's place, see what I can find. Whatever I dig up, you can take to that Pinkerton boss of yours. What?
Wait, you aren't exactly stealthy.
What is that supposed to mean?
She means you're about as subtle as a bag of hammers, gorgeous. Given your luck, you'd get gotten hanged by sundown.
Wow.
Okay. Well, fine. I won't linger where I'm not appreciated.
Well, if it's appreciation you're looking for, you might want to start with a bath.
I feel bad. I think we hurt his pride.
Don't. He's a modern-day caveman. He just needs to find something to smash with a rock.
He does have a point, though. With Tom preoccupied, it'd be the perfect time to go through his place.
I do need all the evidence I can get before my meeting.
Well, there's no question that we are a lot more discreet than Hoyt. And he said it himself. Even if we were caught, we both work for Tom. We'd have a reason to be there.
You ever cross paths with this McDonald?
Nope.
Must be a big bounty on his head if Gus Santiago's chasing him. I know I've been distracted lately.
Distracted by what? Just tell me, because I can't make sense of anything you do anymore.
I'm the same person, Augustus. I haven't changed.
Same person. Well, maybe you haven't been paying attention. But 2 weeks ago, you wouldn't step foot in town. And now you're sitting around at Hagen's with Abby Walker, a stranger, and Hoyt Rollins, a lowlife. Why?
I was trying to protect a friend.
And here I was thinking we were friends. We used to have each other's backs. Now I see I gotta watch my own.
Good. I heard talk of this Eli McDowell. He's got a reputation for being one crafty bastard. He's dangerous. Got a dozen notches on his belt. If we get close, I go in first. Nobody makes a move unless I say so. You got it?
Understood.
All right. Tell me one thing about you that nobody else knows.
Oh, easy. I have a birthmark on my butt in the shape of a
strawberry. We stopped at a watering hole. He's an exhibitionist.
Hello, strawberry. All right, now you.
Right. Something nobody knows. My father was never fond of Liam. He wasn't from that world, and Daddy didn't trust him. So at first, I had to sneak out to meet him. And of course, Liam didn't have much money, so he surprised me with a picnic at the Boston Public Gardens. But all he brought were a couple of apples. I was starving, talked for hours. Stayed out so late, we watched the lamplighter go to work. My father was furious. Didn't matter. I knew Liam was the one.
Also, he defied your father then. Abby, would you say that he was a risk taker? Did you say that he was reckless?
Kate.
Do you think that going west was an impulsive thing, or could he have been running away from enemies, you know, say, in the Boston police?
What exactly are you saying, Kate?
I am asking you how well you knew your husband.
Of course, you would be up here saving yourself. You know what? It would be better if he did shoot me. Because then I wouldn't have to be in another room.
You would walk around
for another
here, like
single
you're better
second.
Than everyone else. Let me tell you,
you
something.
You know what? All of this is yours.
Are you trying to get yourself killed?
So you're the outlaw that everyone's after, right?
And you're Abby. Your boss told me.
Oh, yeah, you two were chatting at the bar. Didn't seem altogether friendly, was it?
Oh, I can see why you got his attention.
Did you know him? In Texarkana?
I don't know what you're on about, but I'll tell you this for free. Your sheriff down there might be the most dangerous man in Texas.
What?
Well, I wish we'd gone to Mexico, Tommy.
Wish you'd gone to Mexico?
Yeah, it wouldn't have made much of a difference. There's no place I can run. Santiago won't find me.
Stop running. Turn yourself in.
He'll gun me in the street, Tommy.
No, no! I will take you in myself. You're gonna get the rope. It's better than the alternative.
Just another weary outlaw, huh, Tommy?
Tired and small. Getting his neck stretched out for a crowd of people.
Spare me from that, won't you, Tommy?
Maybe
in another life, okay? Tommy, I know I've done wrong, and I know I don't deserve it, but there must be some small bit of grace here for me at the end, yeah? Come on, Tommy, come on.
I will not do this for you.
Hey! Please don't make me hurt her, Tommy.
Put it down.
Eli, we can work this out.
It's the only way you can help. I'm not gonna do that for you.
Some just like I knew you were.
I'm not hiding anymore.
I'm tired of watching the bodies pile up. And Tom murdered Liam Collins. I wish you had come to me sooner. I mean, why wouldn't you trust me with something like this? I think I know who murdered Liam Collins. And It wasn't Tom.
Why didn't you tell me about her?
I was offered money, and I took it.
Ladies and gentlemen, place your bet.
That's about enough for one night.